Join us now as we take another stroll down Depot Square here at the Lake Superior Railroad Museum at the temporarily closed St. Louis County Depot in downtown Duluth. You'll recall from an earlier episode we told you about these storefronts that surround the museum artifacts, and here is one of those storefronts with a very special story. Just like the mythical small village in the Scottish Highlands that appears out of the fog once every 100 years for one day only and finds romance, we have a similar story here, just like that Lerner and Lowe musical from 1947. Our story, though, is that the Grambsch family takes their candy store behind me and brings it back to life for one day every year. The story starts, well, with me in 1924. Normally closed to the public, we're inside the Grambsch family candy store. This is circa 1924. Ben Grambsch is a carpenter. He made all this, but he really wanted to be a candy maker. So he started in downtown on Main Street in Loyal, Wisconsin, the Grambsch Family Candy Store. And now, every year, for one day, the descendants of Ben come back and start making candy again. Ben Grambsch died in 1966 delivering candy, and the shop was closed. And it sat that way until sometime in the late 1970s, when Ben's son, Clyde Grambsch, got the idea of donating all of this from the now closed and just mothballed candy store and factory here to the Railroad Museum. And as I said, every year, three generations of the Grambsch family come back and recreate the magic of making candy the old-fashioned way, using the copper kettle and the cold stone slab to do the handiwork that makes candy the old-fashioned way by hand. It was a family tradition that they would come back every year and continue to do so on the Saturday after Thanksgiving, this year, November 28th. And they missed only one time in all those over 30 years. And unfortunately, that was last year during a blizzard. Clyde used to sit here, rock, and direct the magic in front of him. He would tell his two children, Bob Grambsch and Camilla Anderson, exactly how to make the candy the way he would. He left us at age 97. But I can assure you that this candy store will resurrect itself just like that mythical town of Brigadoon and be back in operation as it was meant to be. You know, that makes me think about family traditions. We honor them when we remember them. And that's what we do every year with the Grambsch family that donated all this and their wonderful family history to the museum. You probably have some time-honored traditions in your family. Maybe today would be a good day to reminisce and, I don't know, call somebody in the family you haven't talked to for a while and say, hey, remember when Grandpa used to do this? Because that's what we do. We remember when Grandpa Clyde used to make candy. Join us, if you can, on the 28th of November. It's a Saturday. The smells fill the entire museum of sassafras and wintergreen and cinnamon. And it's magic to watch that candy be made. And then, of course, the best part, take some home with you. It's all free. Well, anyway, we're going to come back tomorrow with our, ready for this, 100th episode. Incredible. Join us for our centennial celebration tomorrow. We'll be back here with our 100th episode. In the meantime, as I've always said, and you know it by heart, but you need to do it now more than ever. You cover your coughs, don't touch your face, keep a social distance, wash your hands. If you're sick, stay home, and then stay tuned for the 100th episode tomorrow. In the meantime, let's take care of each other.